Well, Pops and the whole team, they went to Puerto Rico. And I tell you right now, the old man knew that if he had moved, Pops in the whole training session out of the 50 states, Jenkins couldn't pull anything. And Jenkins was not welcomed in Puerto Rico at all. Long story short, Jenkins fucked up a major career belonging to a former boxing star. Let's just say he no longer boxes and no longer is able to walk. And Jenkins made sure of that. All Puerto Ricans expressed their hatred for Jenkins whenever he came to Puerto Rico. They called him El Diablo Negro. What Jenkins did to that boxer was worse than any abuse you could have ever seen, man. I mean, shortened his fight purse, had him constantly fighting and hardly training. It was a matter of time before that man's skill and body would diminish. Man, he made him fight till he was 38 years old, way past his prime. Every time the old man and Pops go to PR, they always pay him a visit. His name was Luis Fernandez. And Luis fought hard, and his record was a hard 56-10 with two championships. He's considered a legend in the sport. Stanton was going over the team budget, and Delancey was packing the equipment. And the old man was packing clothes and talking with his wife from his office phone. The old man never took his wife with him to Puerto Rico. The old man felt that loved ones during training was a big distraction. But for some reason, he was allowing Ebony to come along. I know it's weird, but the real reason he let her go was because he knew that Jenkins would get to her and tamper with her. Just to throw Pops off his game. The old man was a master planner, quick and merciless. Back in New York, Jenkins was furious. He wanted to sabotage this fight so bad, he searched high and low till he finally got some information on the old man and Pop's whereabouts. Jenkins had Smith training hard. He also had a lot of his dirty workers trying to look for Pop's, anyone close to Pops, just to fuck with him. That fool did this for a whole month, man. November had come, and Pops was still in Puerto Rico. The old man had him tip-top shape. He was ready. The old man had him tip-top shape and ready. In mid-November, the old man had gotten a phone call. His wife had told him that the corner store had burned down. That's right. The bodega was gone. The gym. The old man just laughed and said, well, at least the insurance will cover it. Then hung up. The old man just adjusted his glasses and continued to train Pops. He was composed. I guess he had no choice but to be. Delancey approaches the old man and asks him,
¿Qué pasa, viejo?
What's wrong? The old man tells him, Ah, mijo. Keep hitting the bag, Kelvin. I'll be back. Listen, Delancey. Jenkins. He burned down the bodega. Delancey was furious and said out loud,
That motherfucker!
Pop started hitting the speed bag and asked, Hey man, what's wrong, Pacheco? But the old man would not have Pops distracted. He told Pops, Nothing, get back to work. Stanton just walked up to the old man and said, He burned down the bodega? He burned down the bodega? Come on, Manny. I think that's too much. A little too much. The old man replied, You think? I don't think this. I don't know. I can't retaliate. I have to keep it clean. Keep Kelvin's mind clear. After the fight, we will handle it. Seguro que sí. The old man then yells out to his brothers, Tell my wife to pack and get down here. Pop stopped hitting the bag briefly, just to notice exactly what was going on, try to put everything together. Pops hit the bag again, noticing that the old man turned his head. The old man then called the speed bag session to a halt in order to put Pops to hit the heavy bag. Pops asked the old man, Hey man, what's going on? And why, for the first time ever, are you letting your wife come down here, man? The old man wanted to tell him, but knew that he needed Dad undistracted, clear in the mind. So he said, Listen, Kevin. You keep your mind on boxing. I will keep my mind on my problems, okay? That's what you're here for, to train. Now, get in there and start to spar. Let's go. Come on, you two, get off your asses. Pops just looked at him and just started to spar. As Pops hit the bag that he felt was in front of him, simply because his sparring partner wasn't moving either. He was just as confused as Pops. So as soon as he started hitting his sparring partner, he said to the old man, You know, I am your friend, man. You can tell me what the hell's going on. The old man then just got frustrated, adjusted his glasses, clenched his fists, put one finger up, and said furiously, Excuse me? I think I told you we were here to train, not to counsel each other. Are you a fighter or are you a fucking shrink, goddammit? Now focus! Fucking spa. Pops just started the spa again. The old man turned away and felt real bad. But he had no choice but to treat Pops in that fashion in order to keep his head in the fight. Anything else was just not needed. 4 hours later, the old man's wife was there, safe and sound. Jenkins sent the message by burning down the boat digger. But all he really did was start something very, very drastic within Manny Pacheco. See? The old man had once worked with Smith before he signed with Jenkins. So the advantage was the old man's. And Jenkins knew this. Man, Jenkins was very, very nervous about losing. As the fight drew closer, Jenkins would really do some crazy, crazy shit, man, but always failed. But I heard that Jenkins had Brody beat up Ebony's younger brother. All this was going on, and Pops was totally oblivious to this shit. It was kept from him, but for good reason. Pops didn't like Brody. See, they too have history. Pops is actually the one who retired Brody. He hit Brody so hard that he fell on his shoulder outside of the ring, breaking it, causing permanent injury. Pops hated the way that went down and apologized many times. But Brody was just downplaying him. And Pops just learned to accept it after a long period of time. Brody, man, he hated Pops for the situation in itself. I can assure you, it had nothing to do with jealousy. Ebony knew about her brother getting beat up. He was laying in the hospital in New York City, and she had no way of seeing. It was like they were in hiding from the mob. All this just to keep Pop's focus for the fight. I tell you, Ebony slept uneasy, but always held it from Pops during that time. She couldn't tell him. And she knew this. Her little brother was 17 and laid in the hospital with a fractured skull, 2 broken clavicles. But Ebony kept that all inside. The old man went to Pop's room at about 2:30 a.m. and told him to be ready in 20 minutes. Pops complied. No lip, no frustration. Regardless being half asleep, he went to it. The old man sat Pops down and then shared a secret with him. He had shown Pops his punch stats. He showed him his punch stats that would equal every punch he threw so far in his career. He took out a piece of paper and asked Pops, "What do you see that's so odd but yet natural?" Pops just looked at the paper and said, "I see that I only threw 45 shots and landed 45, Man. The old man leaned forward and said, "Exactly. You, my friend, have a technique that's very rare, my friend. 45 shots in all 15 fights. You have to work on this. ASAP." Pops was stunned and just smiled. Stanton and Delancey just walked in too. The old man's room. And the plan began. The 45 was then created.